Hey Joe, how's it going?
Great, John. How you doing?
Good. Thanks for stopping by Marketing.
Hey, absolutely. Always a pleasure for engineering and marketing to come together.
It really is. And we love being in marketing because we see some of the new products that are happening, some of the new technologies that ATS is bringing forth, and the way that we're dealing with our customers. And I see you've brought by some new technology here for us.
Yeah, new but not so new. Zipper fins is what we have here, and we've been doing this for some time, manufacturing zipper fins. They've been popular for years and years. They find a specific place in the market depending on their need, and we've deployed them with great success.
Wow. So what exactly is a zipper fin? Can you explain that a little? Is it like a manufacturing process, or is it like a special technology, or is it both? Or?
Yeah, so a zipper fin is a multi-step assembly process, the zipper itself being made out of a sheet metal that's formed into a specific shape. That material is usually aluminum or copper, and it has some certain features on the fin itself. When placed together, each fin is interlocked into its neighbor. So
like
when
each
assembled,
one of these?
Yeah, each one of these has an individual zipper that interlocks with the fin next to it. When it's all assembled and soldered to the base of the heat sink, it's a rigid body.
Oh, okay.
So very reliable as far as fin density, shape, and size.
Now, why would a customer want us to do zipper fin? Would this assist them in some way, like in cost or manufacturing quality or maybe technology, like a better technology heat transfer, that kind of thing? Or?
Yeah, so zipper fins compared to another design that you may have heard of, a bonded fin.
Oh, yeah.
So a bonded fin is quite simply, well, it's similar to this, but the tooling is a lot higher. So one of the benefits with a zipper fin is you can actually manufacture a very high aspect ratio fin pitch, fin profile, without that high tooling cost. So if you want really tall fins, really thin fins, and really tightly packed fins, zipper fin may be the solution.
That's for more surface area, right?
Surface area, exactly. And also, this type of zipper fin creates a duct.
So
oh, really? When the zipper is covering the entire fin fin field, it creates a ducted airflow, which is much better for thermal performance.
Okay, so these are hollow in here, and the reason
right.
for that is because it's ducted airflow.
It's
that
a ducted airflow.
So it actually creates both a heat sink and actually a duct in one piece.
Right, exactly. We use a lot of this as well for our active heat sinks with air movers, fans, or blowers. This heat sink here, for instance, is in a system, but it's ducted flow by this zipper pack. And also, some customers even put an interface material on top of a zipper pack like this and conduct heat to the lid of a chassis.
Wow, that's incredible.
Yeah.
It's really impressive how that can be used for different applications. Now, do customers find that they use this kind of thing instead of kinds of other types of heat sinks? You know, you just mentioned some applications, but there are specific areas like with military or, for example, appliances, or is it really cost or volume driven?
It's mainly volume driven. So ATS, here we have a lot of zipper fins tooled up and ready to deploy on a heat sink base. So depending on the complexity of the base itself and the need for the surface area and fin density, based on the airflow, these things have to align to be able to utilize a zipper fin. There are just some things we can't do via extruding or skiving or forging that we can do with a zipper fin. For instance, either in copper or aluminum, we can have a zipper fin that's 0.2 millimeters thick. We can't do that with a skiving process or an extruding process.
Wow. Hey, you mentioned skiving. So would a customer choose this over skiving, choose a zipper fin, or would they make a decision based on some other parameters, not just because they like one or the other?
Yeah, so again, you know, it's really dependent upon what the need is of the solution itself. Low volume skiving is comparable to a zipper fin profile, and most customers choose to skive first, but at high volume, there is a break-even point where it makes sense to go to a zipper fin instead of skiving. So when skiving, we can skive aluminum and we can skive copper. A copper heatsink skived is very heavy. One of the benefits of a zipper fin heatsink is we can have a copper base that gives us that heat spreading.
Oh, okay.
We can
like
have
this one.
An aluminum fin profile, which reduces the weight significantly.
Okay.
Yeah. So we can combine those.
So there are other technologies that people use with thermal management, right? Like such as ATS's patented maxi grip and patented super grip technologies that allow, you know, a really nice connection with the chip and allow for the use of phase change material. Mm-hmm. Could those also be applied? Could you use those, for example, with zipper fin or no?
Yeah. So as you see on these zipper fin heat sinks, the fins are neighboring each other all the way through
really
throughout
tight.
The whip.
Yeah.
If you imagine this was much smaller, we can easily have a maxi grip or super grip over the middle portion. But we don't always have to have the fin field throughout the entire width of the heatsink. We can split the fin pack up if we need to allow specific features on the heatsink, or clip-on methods such as the maxi grip, super grip, Z clip, for instance.
Wow. Or in this case, this is like, isn't this push pin or something like that?
Yeah, push pins would work as well. This is actually hard mounted onto the board. This heatsink is cooling many components, actually about 12 total components
right.
on the bottom of this heatsink.
Wow.
So this one spreads the entire length and utilizes the copper for spreading. And again, it was that weight factor we wanted to reduce, so we used aluminum fins, which need to be nickel plated when you solder.
How about these two other? These are obviously different applications from this one, but they seem to all use zipper fin.
Yeah, so the good thing about a zipper as well is if you were to stamp a fin for the zipper, you can also, during that stamping process, allow for holes in the fins to allow
closer?
To press in heat pipes.
Okay.
Yeah. So here we have one tool for the fin itself to
okay.
allow for the heat pipes, and you can see this, this is the base of the heat sink. That touches the component, which is the evaporator section, and the condenser section is actually the zippers away from the component and then mounted to the board. But again, the zipper fin profile allows us to reduce weight significantly, especially with a heat pipe application.
It's very light, yeah.
Yeah. And it's the one-time tooling, low-cost production.
And what about this particular one?
Yeah, so this is an all-copper solution, which is a stamped base, flat, basic material, and a standard zipper fin copper fin profile that's soldered on. So again, it's a multi-step process where you make the zipper and a long zipper, break off the zipper to your specific width, place it on the heatsink, and wave solder.
That's excellent.
Yeah.
Wow, this is great.
Yeah, so again, I mean, when performance is critical, you know, these are performing some of the best numbers for heatsinks. Per that, you know, given envelope, again, because we can significantly increase the aspect ratio,
okay.
reduce the fin thickness, and also the fin density.
And we've done a lot of these, right? So it's really part of our design services and the way we
right.
really help our customers get to the exact solution they need, right? Not just some off-the-shelf solution, but say, okay, let's get the best cost and the best effective heat transfer.
Right, exactly. So while we have many of extrusion profiles in stock, we also have many zipper fins in stock
okay.
as well, that we can pick and choose from depending on length, height, and orientation on a base to utilize for a solution. They need not all be square. You know, we have some, you know, unique fins that are tooled up, and also we can use the zipper fin to allow for a fin profile to be a circular, 360
okay. oh,
degrees.
Oh, interesting.
And we use that with a lot of active heat sinks and fans.
Wow, that sounds great.
So an axial type of zipper fin.
Wow, this is great.
So LEDs, you mentioned some of the industries, you know, LEDs embedded, military definitely, and, you know, telecom and datacom as well.
Yeah. Consumer and appliances, I would imagine, maybe because they need that volume and that price.
Yep, exactly. And once you do tool up, if it's something new, then the production, it's a very low-cost solution, absolutely.
This is great. Well, I guess if people want to know more about zipper fins, they could just contact us at qats.com, I guess.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, we're here. We're designing a lot of these and others. Again, if this is the right solution, we have the options.
Sounds great.
Yeah.
Joe, thanks a lot for coming by.
Sure thing, John.
Thank you. Excellent. Thank you.